Okay. So to finish cleaning up these areas and to make sure we don't have any leftover debris, I haven't yet done the legs and the hands and all that remains, but just to check my work so far, it's a good idea to create a new background layer above your sketch layer. So there's my sketch. So I'm going to create a new layer with that little post-it icon in the layer window. You could also go up to layer and say new layer. And I'm going to fill it, edit, fill, or I could use the paint bucket, but I like this because I can pick the precise fill. And I'm going to fill it instead of with white, as we've done in the past, with 50% gray. So it's going to match this gray. And I say, okay. So the benefit of that is I can see if there's any little debris left off to the side of these edges I've cut out. And if I'm ever unsure, like it looks gray there, I can just turn that layer off and say, well, sure enough, it is gray there. So that's not a problem. I didn't accidentally cut into it. It also will show you if you have little remnants. I have auto select layer turned on. So if I see something I want to delete, 100% opacity brush, fairly soft edged, pressure sensitive, I can clean that up pretty quickly. That's kind of fine tuning. Now I know we don't have the textures blending yet. There's a lot of correction we need to do, but I just want to get it all cut out cleanly now. So I can move now to the legs and arms, and because there's a lot going on there, I'm going to open up my layer group and take it kind of one at a time. So I'll start with the hands. And this is a good place to start this demo today. Let's do the other one. Because this is a soft texture. I want to keep that furry appearance. And I don't really have that anywhere else on my creature. So instead of trying to lasso and get all that grass, I'm just going to do it directly. Using my 100% eraser. But I'm going to make it even softer. So I had it at about a 90% hardness to have just a slight soft edge. Now I want to go for more like a 50% hardness. That doesn't mean it's a lower opacity. It's still taking away everything. But now it's a pressure-sensitive brush that's also a lot softer at the edge. And I'll show you why that matters for things like hair or feathers, things that are somewhat transparent. Because if I zoom in now, I don't want it to be cut out as though it's a piece of paper. I want it to feel like bristly, individually transparent hairs just grouped together. And this can be a lot more subjective, how much you leave, how long the individual hairs are, how broken up you leave them. I might even go for a slightly smaller brush. This is very zoomed in now. Now, if you need a shortcut while you're cleaning up, because I just noticed this kind of annoying red edge on this back arm, and there was some debris, you can hit Command and turn your tool immediately into the Move tool, which if you have a layer select on your Move tool, that allows you to erase between layers very quickly. All right, so I might do something pretty loose to begin with, like that, but see I'm leaving a lot of rough edges. Not trying to be too obsessive about it. Coming in, keep cutting away. Make sure I don't have any debris left on the outside. So I'm using my navigation shortcuts, Command Plus, Command Minus. I'm using the space bar and then to change it to kind of the grab tool and then just moving it around, going in at different depths to get this work done. All of these skills will help us in all future projects, especially digital painting, when we're having to move around this digital canvas much more fluidly than we're required to right now. Okay, now I have a shadow under the hair on this side. That might be a good opportunity for using the magic wand. Having contiguous turned on, a standard tolerance, holding down shift to add to it, and then just going over my eraser, but it will be a soft-edged erase. And then I back that up with what I've been doing. But I certainly don't want to leave any kind of black edge, any outline. And you always have your history if you end up erasing too much or going too far. Now for the claws, I'm going to want to use a slightly sharper brush. So let me stay on the fur for now. And that gray comes through really cleanly to show me where I've erased. And it will hopefully show off anything that's darker than the gray or anything that's lighter than the gray. So I can correct that. That's why middle gray can be a nice background when we're just finishing off. When we finish this assignment, we're going to cut it out completely and save it as what's called a PNG file. And that allows us to see how clean your edge is. It won't have any background behind it at all. And showing in PhotoBucket, it will just take on whatever the background is of the web page. So if we look at it in SlideShow, it will have a black background. If we look at it on just the regular PhotoBucket site, it will have a gray background much like this. You won't be able to hide any white debris you left. So obviously we're not cutting things out by painting pixels to cover them up. We're just removing. And the softer the texture, the softer the brush we use to remove. We can even punch little holes. Okay. So I've got the fur. If I turn that off, I see the hand underneath. I can get rid of that just by hitting Command to get to the Move tool and then just erase where it overlaps. So now even though we're working with lots of layers, we're having good control of them. And I love using the tablets and the pressure sensitivity. Helps me remove a lot with a lot of accuracy. Okay. Now, while I'm still on that brush, I want to use it for this foreground. Bunch of hair here. Hold down Command on Layer Select. Okay, I'll just use my stylus a little bit more freely. Hear kind of the clicking of it as I slash at this texture, give me more of a fur-like direction. It's just a way to start it, and then it's going to get softened and more softened as I go back. I'm basically shaving it back. This is a very dense fur, so it still has fairly smooth edges, if not really sharp, from where all these hairs mass together. Sometimes you just travel along with them. And it's not like I have to preserve every hair I see in my reference. I can create the amount of overlap I want. And I still have a lot of work to do to make these textures work. I might even decide to have this kind of fur texture somewhere else on the creature. And I can use the clone stamp tool to blend or copy this texture into another aspect of the creature. We have lots of options left to us. So it can be hard to see how much I've removed with all this stuff behind overlapping. But honestly, where it overlaps the interior of the creature, I'm not as concerned about as that outside edge. That outside edge is really telling. And that's why I filled the background in with gray. So already that's looking more believable. Now I'm getting close to the claws. They're a harder structure. Oops. So I want to go to a hardness of the brush. It's a little bit stronger. Now things like toenails, claws, they're opaque, but they have just a slight translucence at the edge. So you can decide how soft or how hard to go with its edge. But it's not the same as scaly skin, for instance. So these are like the horns around the head of my creature. I might go slightly softer just to give me a little bit more illusion of smoothness. And each time you pick up your stylus, it is saving it in your history. That's why we save at least 200 states or 300 states in our histories. Because sometimes we'll accidentally erase something and then not notice it until much later. That's not a good thing. Now, because I'm overlapping with the leg, I'm actually going to leave that shadow a little bit in. Because that will help it set off whatever is behind it. I wouldn't do that if it was on the outside edge. These are on internal edges. Sometimes you can use the shadows that are already there. And you'll get a lot better at making these selections and moving your stylus with a lot more accuracy and confidence. So I have the three toes there. Three-toed sloth. Move over to the other hand. Hold down Command to select that layer because I have auto-select on for my move tool. Don't cut too much. And here, in order to help it stay smooth, I'm actually zoomed out quite a bit. Try to just get nice, even passes. Sometimes when you zoom in, you'll be more detail-oriented, but you won't get the smoothness overall. Because this is on the outside edge, I don't want to leave much of that shadow. Just a hint of it's okay. But I don't want the illusion of an outline around these claws. Those are cut out. Now let's focus on the feet. And I can just jump around now. Hold down Command, select the layer, increase my